Hi friends, welcome you all to another edition of QuickTip videos brought to you by Data Platform Central. In this weekly edition, we are going to continue our journey with Azure Data Factory by exploring some of its new features. The previous two videos, we looked at how we can use some of the cool features which got recently introduced in Azure Data Factory. So this week, we are coming with another good enhancement which is introduced within the Power Query transformation available within Azure Data Factory. So now the enhancement has made it possible for us to create multiple outputs using the same Power Query activity. This comes very handy for the developers by reducing the development effort, especially in cases where we require applying certain set of data mashup transformations by using native Power Query logic inside your data, and then later they use the data in multiple levels. A typical example can be the case where we are dealing with some sales data, where we have the data of orders coming from a system with some lookup based information like the customer information, the product information, the vendor information, etc. And at the end of all the transformations being applied, we require the data to be fed into our analytical system as it is. And we also require corresponding data to be built at different levels, like say sales advisor level, to be fed into the employer related systems for paying them their commissions, which will be based on their sales, or maybe at product level for feeding them into a planning system where we need to do some futuristic product planning based on the current product performance. So this is a typical scenario that comes in most of the retail based projects. So we'll look at the POC or the proof of concept for such a scenario in this demo session. So let's see, without wasting any time, a quick demo of how we can set it up using a single Power Query transformation to define multiple outputs which can be used for multiple purposes by building data at different levels. Let's start by going to the Azure portal and let's open up the SQL databases which are currently available in the Azure portal, and I can see that there is an instance which is already present. So I'm going to create my staff table inside this. So the staff table will be used for getting some details for the corresponding orders by looking up. So let's connect to this server from our management studio. So let's go connect to database engine. We can enter the name of the server which you can copy from the homepage and paste it here, and then let's pass the username and the password. So now that the database is connected, let's open the database and let's open a new query window, and we are going to create the staff table with the data. So I'll just open that script here and we are going to create it. So the staff table script is opened and let's execute it so that the table will get created inside your existing SQL database instance. And we'll be creating one more Azure SQL instance which will be used as our sync system. So we have created the table now. If you go and refresh it, you'll be able to see the table. Expand and you should be able to see the table with the data. There will be around 15 rows inside our staff table. So we have the staff table now available. So now that the staff table is available, let's go and create the pipeline which will have the Power Query activity. So let's go to the ADF Studio for that purpose, and from the home page you can go to the other tab and we are going to create a new pipeline. So let's go to pipeline, new pipeline, and then we are going to call the Power Query activity inside this. So using Power Query activity, we will be able to do data wrangling transformations inside our ADF pipeline. We have already seen that. So let's go to the Power Query, and inside that you can see the Power Query activity here. So if you go to the Power Query activity settings, you can see that you need to first map it to a corresponding Power Query window. So what we can do is, like, we need to create a new instance of a Power Query window, and first thing that it will ask you for is a source data set. So we will be creating two source data sets. One will be the one which comes from our staff table, and the other one will correspond to our CSV file which we have uploaded to the Azure Data Lake. So I have set an Azure Data Lake storage and I have uploaded the file. If you go to my Azure storage, you can see a container inside that. Go to containers, and there is a container for store orders. This contains our CSV file. This is the same CSV file we'll be using for this demonstration as well. So let's go to the ADF package and we are going to create a new data set. So let's create a new linked service which is going to point to our Azure Blob Storage and it is going to be a CSV file. So let's go to the Azure Blob Storage. We have already created the linked service, so we can use the same thing, or if you want to create a new one, that also is possible. So let's browse and let's see that there is a store order here and there is a store order CSV file inside that. So let's click on OK. So and the first row is obviously the header, so click on OK. This will make sure that the ADF pipeline is able to take the schema information from your file itself based on the header row. So the first data is now ready. Automatically you can see the data being loaded into your Power Query editor. Now the second part is to add the data set for getting the staff information. So let's click on add and the new data set will be enabled. Again go and add the new linked service. This time it is going to come from a Azure SQL database. So let's create a linked service. Let's point to the subscription that we have. Let's point to the server name, which is Ent SQL Server. And inside that we have a database called Demo SQL Server. This is where we have our staff table. And you can pass the authentication, which will be the same username and the password we used to connect from our management studio. So we'll enter the username and password. Let's click on test connection to make sure that the connection to our instance is successful. Now that the connection is successful, let's go ahead and create this new linked service. Now it will ask you to point to the table. We already have the table created now, so let's point to the staff table and automatically the schema will be taken from that connection. So let's click on OK. So now we have the both the source data sets ready. So one part of the source came from our file and the second part of the source came from the table that we just created in one of our Azure SQL instances. So now that we have both the sources ready, now the rest of the part we'll be doing it inside the Power Query window. And we'll be using the native Power Query transformations for all these logic implementations. So if you see, we have two sources. One will come from the delimited text, which is inside the Azure Data Lake, and the other one will come from the table. And they have a user query, which is your default output that will be created by the Power Query editor. We can define more outputs if you want and redirect them. So we'll be defining some more outputs apart from this default output. So the first thing that we should do is like we should try to merge this data into single data. So if you see the user query, which is your output, it contains the sales advisor ID, but it doesn't have any details about who these sales advisors are. That part of the detail you should get it from the table, because the table has the details of the sales advisor. The staff ID here corresponds to the staff advisor ID, which is there in your output. So we need to merge them. Before you merge two table entities, we need to make sure that the data type of the columns which are used in the merge operation are the same. So the first thing we need to do is like we need to go to Azure SQL table and see what is the data type of this. By default, this is taken as whole number, which is correct. But if you go to the delimited text, because it comes from a CSV file, it will be taken as text. If you go to the data type, it's called text. So you need to first change it to whole number. And similarly for the order date, you need to change it from text to date. These are some of the things you need to do prior to merging the outputs. And once it is made it into a text, then we will also require separating out the year, because we need it for grouping. So what I would do is like I'll try to extract this year information from this date into a separate column. So for that purpose, I'll go to add column and I'll use the extract option and last characters. So last four characters will represent the year. Automatically it will extract the year information and add it to a new column. So let's name this order year and let's make the data type integer. So let's go to the home and let's make it into a whole number because it's integer. So now what we have done is like we have extracted the year information from the date and we have also made the sales advisor into a whole number. And now we are going to merge between both of them. So for that purpose, come to user query and you can see in the home there is an option for merge queries. Click on merge queries and choose the first option because you are going to merge the result into the same table. So you have the user query where you have this sales advisor column. Select the column and for the right table you select Azure table and there you select the staff ID. And you can select the join type as inner join because you know that every one of those sales advisor will have a corresponding information. In case you want the details irrespective of the match, you will go for left out. So now you have got a perfect match. You got all the 1000 rows matched against. So now when you click on OK, the output will change into a merged output. You will have columns coming from both the tables if you see. So now if you see, there are tables which are coming against each of these rows as a result of this merge. And from this, now you need to only include the corresponding columns that you need. So you need first name, last name, email and phone corresponding to the sales advisor. So you can include all of them, and if you want you can use the original column name as prefix. If you don't want it, you can uncheck it and click on OK. So you get these additional columns added to your output. Now if you see the names are in two columns, so you need to merge them into a single column. So what you can do is like you can select both of them, and there is an option to merge the columns. So what you can do is like you can go to the transformations and you have the option of merging the columns. So you can click on merge and you can take the separator as space, and the new column will be named as advisor name. Now that the merging is also done, we have the data ready for our base table. Now using these data, we are going to create three output streams, one targeted for each of our target tables, which we will be designing against our sync system, which is the Azure SQL database. So for the first one would be the table which contains all the data for 2020. The second one would be the table which contains all the data for 2021. That was the reason why we created that order year column inside our table. So now let's first create the first table based on this year. So before we create that table, let's just duplicate this because we would require it again. So the first one will be having the complete data now, and also the second copy will also have the complete data. So now let's go to the first one and let's apply a filter, and the filter would be applied for the year 2021. And whilst that is loading up, let's go to the second query, and the second query will still contain the entire data because we have actually duplicated it from the main query itself before applying the filter. So the second query will still have all the data, and the first query will only have the data for the 2020. As you see in the steps, it has that filter applied, so that's why you see only 2021 data here. Whereas if you go to the duplicate copy that you created, that will not have that filter step, it will contain every data. Now we are going to again duplicate one more from there, and the second query we are going to apply a filter of 2020. So this will only contain the data for 2020. So the default output will contain 2021 data, and the last one we are going to apply a aggregation. So we require along with the detailed data an aggregated data based on the sales advisor, so as to calculate their commissions based on the sales. So quite often if you see, their commission that is paid out to the salesperson will be directly proportional to the amount of sales that they did during a period. So what we are going to do here is that we are going to calculate the commission for each of the sales advisors for each of the years, which means that we need to basically group the data against the sales advisor name and the year. And for each of the sales advisor in each of the year, we'll be calculating the total revenue that they brought to the company. And then out of this revenue, they will be paid a percentage as the commission. So let's say that the percentage for ease of calculation, let's say that the percentage is 10%, which means that for calculating the percent for each of these sales advisors, we'll have to first group the data by sales advisor by order year and get the total order amount or the revenue for which they have done the sales. Then apply this 10% logic on top of that so as to calculate their commissions which can be paid. So now that we have the duplicate copy which contains the base data as it is, now we are going to apply the group by on top of it. For applying group by, you can go to the home page or you can even take it from the transformation, both the places it's available. So you can go to the home page, click on group by, and you need to go to advanced because we require multiple columns to be grouped by. So the first column that we need to group by is this advisor name, and we also need to group by order year. So this will ensure that we'll get the total calculated for every sales advisor for every year. And then for the aggregations, first we need a symbol count which will give them the orders which were processed by those sales advisors during the period, and then we need to also have a revenue, and the revenue will be calculated as the total of the order totals. So we need to put a sum of, and the column would be the order total. So once you do these two calculations, we'll get the corresponding aggregated values for these sales advisors. So as you see, it's automatically calculated the number of orders per sales advisor, and it also automatically calculated the revenue along with that. Now we need to apply over this revenue the 10% calculation. For that purpose, let's go to the add column, and there is a custom column transformation which can be applied for this purpose. So select the custom column transformation Let's name it advisor commission, and this will be calculated as the revenue into 0.1, which will be same as the 10%. So 10% means 10 by 100, which is 0.1. So revenue multiplied by 0.1 will give you the commission that is to be paid out to the corresponding sales advisors, and automatically it will calculate for 41,195. 10% will be 4119.57, similarly for each of the values. So it will automatically calculate the commissions. So now if you see, we have three outputs. So this one we can make it like advisor data, because it is actually giving the data at the level of advisor. So in this way we can duplicate the output stream, and you can add your own logic so as to create your own output streams. And each output stream can be held at whatever level you want, whether you need it at the detail level, whether you need it at any one level, like say in this case we are grouping by advisors. So now that we have everything ready, now we can go to the pipeline. So we can go back to the pipeline and just do the validation to make sure that all of our Power Query transformations are correct, and we can close that. And now we need to go to the sync part. So we have created the outputs there. Now we are going to add the sync corresponding to that. So as to add the sync, we need that new SQL database instance. For that purpose, let's first go to our portal and let's create a new SQL database. I'm going to create a new SQL database, and I'm going to name it sync database for demo. So I'll make it sync database demo, and we'll just use review plus create and click on create. We'll wait for it to be created, and once this database is created, we will create a new linked service to this database, and we'll create three tables inside that. And in these tables we will direct our output streams so that the data will get stored inside the tables which we are creating inside this Azure SQL database. So let's wait for a while. Whilst this deployment is in progress, it will take a short while before which the instance gets deployed. So let's go back to the ADF package, and from here we will be adding it, and let's select the output. So as you see, all the outputs are available here. So for the user query, we will point it to one of the tables, and similarly for the other two queries, we'll point it to similar tables. And in the sync, if you see, you can create the linked service. So click on new, and this will pop up the linked service dataset creation. And here we need to select the Azure SQL database and click on continue. And before selecting it, we need to make sure that our instance is up and running, because we are going to show it to the instance. So I think it's still in progress. We need to wait until the deployment is success. So let's wait. Let's look into the notification tab, and you can see that the deployment is still in progress. So we'll wait for that to be complete, and then once we come back, we can create the linked service inside this to connect to this new instance. So the instance is now created. Now you can click on go to resource, and you can see that the instance is now created. Now if you go back to the management studio and refresh, you can see the new database here. So the new database is now available. So let's go back to the package and create that linked service. So let's go to new, let's select the subscription and the server name, and the database name would be the sync database demo. And then let's use the same username and the password. Let's test the connection, and once it is success, let's go inside. So the connection is successful. Let's click on create, and if you remember, we are going to create new tables. This is a fresh database with no tables inside it, so we will be creating new table, and let's name the table as 2021 data, and make sure that once you click on OK, the table will be mapped. Similarly for the second one, it is going to be 2020. So let's again select the same linked service, click on new, click on Azure SQL database, continue, and let's select the last linked service itself, because it is the same database but only the table will be different. So let's click on create new table. It will be dbo.2020 data, and then finally we will also have one more table which will store the advisor later data. Again click on add, select the advisor data, again click on new. Now again we need to go to the Azure SQL database type, again choose the latest linked service that we created, and again create new table, and this time the table will be called advisor payout, because it's payout data, and click on OK. So now all the outputs are now linked to your Power Query output, which means that whatever processing you are doing inside Power Query, the result of that will be stored in the three output streams, and the corresponding outputs will be directed to the corresponding output sync systems which you have connected. So in this case, you are connecting them to the same Azure SQL database inside different tables. But if you want to direct them to different systems, that's also possible. For example, one of the output you can proceed it to Azure SQL database, another one you can push it to a file, another one you can push it to any other kind of systems, like say Azure Cosmos DB. So different types of systems you can, any supported sync system can be associated as a output to which your output stream can be redirected. There is no restriction inside that. So if you want to see the type of outputs. It supports, you can click on this new and it will show you all the different types of outputs. So these are the standard sync systems which will be supported by the Dataflow. So any one of those systems you can redirect your output. So now that you have completed all these steps, you can just validate it once. So now everything is correct, there is no validation errors. So we will go ahead and publish our changes. This will publish all the changes that we have done, the linked services that we created, the data sets that we created, the Power Query, the pipeline, everything will get published to the ADF repository. So wait for the publishing to be done, which will be done in a short while, and you can keep on monitoring the notification tab. So as you see, whilst you are trying to do that, we got the message that publishing is complete. So now what we can do, we can just go to add trigger, click on trigger now, and then you can try running it. As you see, you will get a small error telling that the internal error, this is because you have named the output starting with a number. So due to some reason in the way that JSON is stored inside, the moment you name an output starting with a number, you will hit this issue. So what we need to do is we need to rename it. So I'm going to rename it as prev data. So let's rename the output to prev data. So we have now renamed the output as prev data. Now let's try validating once again. We can't find any error, which means that the validation was successful. So let's try publishing it once again. So we have already published the changes with that. So now if you try to run it, it should be able to execute the pipeline. So let's go to add trigger, trigger now. So I have published the changes with this prev data change, which I renamed the one of the outputs, and now I am actually executing the package. And now each of these output is going to go into a different table. It is going to create the table and it is going to push the data inside that. So if you click on the view pipeline run, you will be able to monitor the execution of the pipeline. It is going to take around 5-6 minutes. So you need to keep on refreshing and make sure that the execution of the pipeline is a success before you go and check your database. Refresh the execution and you can see that the execution of the package is now success. Once you see this succeeded message and the green tick. Now you can go back and check your database. Just go back to the database and right click on the tables and choose refresh. Wait for the tables to be refreshed. You should see three tables now. One containing the current data, one containing the previous data, and the third one containing the advisor payout. So you can see that there is a table called 2020 data, 2021 data, and advisory payout. So let's first open the 2020 data and see what is the data which is present inside the table. So right click on the table and choose select top 1000 rows, and you can see all the contents in the table. So you have around 43 rows and all of this consists of the 2020 order data. Similarly, if you go to the 2021 data, right click and choose the select top 1000 rows, you can see that it consists of the 2021 rows, which consists of around 957 rows, and all of them will be 2021 data. And similarly, if you go to the third table, this is going to contain the aggregated data at the advisory level. So if you right click and choose the top 1000 rows, you should see 2 rows per advisor. So we'll have 15 into 2, 30 rows. And if you order by the advisor name and then the order year, you can see that for every advisor, we'll have data for both 2020 and 2021. Each year, how many orders they brought to the organization, what was the total revenue from the orders, and correspondingly, their commission will be calculated, which is the 10% of the total revenue. So for a amount of 36,369, the corresponding commission will be 3636, which is the 10% of this. Like this for every sales advisor. So what we have done here is that by making use of a single Power Query activity, we have defined multiple inputs where part of the data comes from the store orders sheet, which was loaded into our Azure data lake, and part of the data came from the database from a table called the staff table containing the details of the staff. Using these two data, by merging them, we created three outputs, one of them having the current year, one of them having the previous data, and finally we also created an aggregated data output where we are calculating the total order or the revenue per sales advisor, and we calculated their corresponding commissions. So this is one of the recent enhancements which got introduced. We extended the Power Query activity so that it supports multiple output streams now, and it can be used for generating multiple table outputs. So from this POC, it's quite evident that we can make use of this cool enhancement which is now available inside our Power Query transformation, so to generate multiple outputs based on the same set of transformations which needs to be applied on our data. We don't have to create separate pipelines or separate execution paths for that. Once we have the single Power Query window where we implement all our logics like merging output from multiple sources and adding any additional transformation on top of it so as to prepare the data in the way we want, then we can make the duplication of that outputs and then we can apply further transformations like we did in this case where we aggregated the output up to the sales advisor level. And then we can define multiple syncs to which we can divert these outputs. So hope this quick video helped you to understand this concept in detail, and as usual, keep sending your feedback and let me know if you have any questions or comments on this. For anyone following this channel for the first time, feel free to like, share and subscribe, and make sure you click on the bell icon for getting notifications. Meet you all soon with another Quick Tip next week. Till then, wish you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Thank you for your time.